Today, I am here to discuss with you about topic gravitation, which is a very important topic in standard 9 physics. We will start with few examples. We will also discuss the famous Apple story. And then, we will move towards very famous universal law of gravitation, given by Newton. After understanding the main statement, we will go for a quick derivation. Now, we are familiar with the very famous Apple story. Newton was sitting under the apple tree, how the apples fell, and he observed and concluded. And finally he came up with a law, which is right now called as universal law of gravitation. Friends, as apple fell, every other object in this universe or on this earth falls down. In those times, motion of celestial bodies as well as tides and airs on new moon day were a bit of mystery. After the concept of gravitation was given by Newton, these small mysteries were solved and the concept became clear in the minds of people. Now, let us move towards the statement. This statement has two parts. First is totally theoretical, another is used for derivation, that is the numerical part. First part, theoretical part, is every object in the universe attracts every other object. The second part is with the force. See, gravitational force is actually a force. So that force is directly proportional to the product of masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between those objects. Now, we will use this second part in the derivation, which is our next topic. Till now, we have discussed few examples based on the concept of gravitation and the very famous universal law given by Newton. Now, let us start with the derivation. Derivation always starts with two parts. One is a figure, then we have to write few statements. In the figure, we can see two objects, one having mass capital M, another one small m. As you see, the distance between these objects is small d. And let us start with the assumption that force F is acting between them. This F is the gravitational force. According to the statement, we have written the first two steps. Force is directly proportional to the product of their mass and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Kindly give numbers whatever steps you are writing. Combining these two steps, the final formula becomes F is proportional to capital M into small m upon d square. Friends, whenever we remove the proportionality symbol, we are doing two things. First, we are removing the symbol which is equal to, and then we are putting a constant. Here, in this formula, you can see a new constant, a new letter, which is capital G. After putting all this, our final formula of gravitational force acting between two bodies is F equals to G capital M into small m upon d square. This is the final formula. The unit of gravitational force is dedicated to the scientists. The unit is Newton. Now, what about capital G? Capital G is called universal gravitational constant. Henry Cavendish, a very famous scientist and physicist, has been credited with calculating the value. Its value is 6.67 into 10 raised to minus 11. Based on the final formula, you can also derive the unit of capital G, that is Newton meter square upon kg square. That's all for today. Thank you.